All right, so today we're going to have a look at building a COVID-19 tracking app. So this isn't going to be anything like the contact tracing apps that are already out there. It's going to show you a dashboard of current numbers for a particular country. But before we can do that, we need to work out if it's even possible to get that information, especially for free, because who doesn't like that? So first up, we're going to jump on Google and see if we can find a free API for this. Now, I've already done some research. In here, I found this COVID19API.com. So this is the API I'll be using for this project. So if we jump over to view the documentation, we can see that there are two endpoints here that we're going to be using. So we've got this day one live, and this just shows each day, order by date, and the number of cases. So on to the next one. So this is what will be on the first screen of our app, and tapping a country will take us to the live stats. So let's get started with a new project. So we got content view, let's just rename that to countries view. Awesome. Next on the list is to sort out the file structure. And of course, we're going to need a group for our model objects. The first thing is to create a country. It will make that decodable. So we'll jump back to the API, to our list of countries. Looks like we have country, slug, ISO2. I'm gonna rename these. I don't like the country, our country object having a country property on it. Doesn't make much sense to me. So let's just change that to name. And then what we'll do now is change the ISO2 to code. Now, because we've done this, we're going to have to decode these manually, but it's great. Swift gives us an easy way of doing that. Now let's decode these. And that's all there is to it. So the next thing is we need to fetch this from the API. So let's create a new group. And we'll call that API service. We're gonna make this a class and we'll have it conform to observable object. So the first function we'll have on here is the ability to fetch countries. So to start this off, we're going to need to grab our URL. And I'm going to force unwrap that. So up here, I'm going to create a state property. So we'll need to define that. So here we've got a generic parameter being passed through to this has data case. Now you can see we've got this error over here as well. Cannot find type T in scope, so we'll need to add that. This here is going to allow us to pass through any type that conforms to decodable, and that'll allow our has data to return the data in that format. So this makes it super easy. This keeps this entire class generic enough so we can tell it what we're expecting to come back from the API. And now we'll create a subscriber. Now what I'd like to do is split this up into a few more functions, because we're going to be reusing the code that makes the actual request. Now in here is where we make use of the information that comes back once the request is finished. I'm going to pass this off to another function. Now we want to receive this on the main thread and erase to any publisher. Now let's create a JSON decoder. So let's use that up here. So we have two closures here. Receive completion and receive value. I only really care about this receive value. So what I'm going to do anyway is I'll create a function for this. We may use it in future. But the receive value is where we're actually going to return the data that we fetched. we'll just pass that in here. Now let's create one for receive value. Here we'll set the state, and that's it. So now we have this error up here, class API service has no initializers. That's because this hasn't been set to anything yet. Now we can create a new case for our state, something like idle perhaps, where it's not doing anything. But I'm just going to set it to is loading for now. If we build and run, successful. Okay, so that's all we should need now to get our list of countries. We haven't done any error handling, but we can get to that a little bit later. Okay, so let's use our new API service. So we've initialized it. Now it's asking for a generic parameter to be passed in. So we can do that right now. And this will be an array of countries. So what we'll do now is fire off a request when this view loads. Now inside the VStack, we'll switch on the state of API service. So now we have this error, initializer init for content requires that country conform to identifiable. That just means we need to add an ID, some sort of unique identifier to our country. Instead of doing that, let's just tell it to use the country code. Now let's have a look. One thing we forgot to do is add observed object. Now this should work. Okay, here we go. List of countries. So these don't seem to be in order, so let's sort them. Here we go. Now in alphabetical order. Tapping on them does nothing at this stage, so let's fix that. So we'll create a detail view for the selected country. And of course we want to pass in the country information. Perfect. Go back over to our API service. And we'll create a new function called getStats. Now this URL takes a parameter. So we'll need to pass that into our getStats. That should be all we need to do in here. So this time we are querying for different data. We haven't created that yet, so let's do that now. Now if we go back to detail country view, we can add in our live stats. So what I'd like to do now is show the most recent stats. You know what, I don't quite like this pop-up. So I think what I'm going to do is change it to a navigation stack. We'll run that again. Here's our list. Thank you. So I've realized I made a mistake here with the live stats struct. Cases had a lowercase c, so I've just changed it to an uppercase and now the data's coming back as it should be. Okay, so that's it for this video. Next time around, we're going to make this look a lot better. I think I'll put in a graph for the last 7 days and then perhaps do some sort of calculation with the last 7 day average, last monthly average, and we'll get a nice dashboard going for each country. Also might add search for the countries list. I think that'll be a nice touch.